Hey guys, in Coral Castle, Ed has carved the moon fountain, which represents the moon, obviously. He has also carved the sun and the sundial, and we have already seen the planets in the planet corner in my other video. Now, what else is left of celestial objects? Stars, of course. Ed gave special attention to Polaris, or the North Star, which is considered the king of stars. The Polaris telescope tracks the movement of the North Star throughout the year. Ed has then moved on to carve constellations, which are groups of stars that make up a specific shape. On the eastern wall, Ed has placed a massive stone that's been dubbed the obelisk. Ed never referred to this as the obelisk, and old newspapers actually call this simply as a star. The name obelisk is a modern-day attribution because no one knows what this means. This object is 15 feet tall, but having placed on top of the wall, which is 8 feet, makes it look taller. This is constellation Taurus. The carving perfectly matches the shape of the constellation in the sky. Taurus means bull in Latin, and it is usually shown with horns on top. Ed has also tried to do this by putting metal antennas on top. If you observe closely, you can see the corroded remains of them on top of the stone. Ed also used these antennas as a radio aerial, but that's a different video in itself. Taurus is very visible in the evening along the eastern horizon, so the quote-unquote obelisk is placed precisely where it should be. This was probably one of Ed's earliest carvings. It is literally rough around the edges and the front surface is extremely uneven. He made it when he was in Florida City at Ed's place. He has carved some interesting information on it. It says, made 1928, moved 1939, born 1887, Latvia, EL. He has also carved a hole near the very top in the shape of a star. It served a practical purpose. Now, think from Ed's point of view. If you were an astronomer, why would you carve a hole on top of a tall object? And now that we know that this structure represents Taurus, what about this structure? What about the Stonehenge? And what is the infamous Repentance Corner? Now, you can find more information in my book, Coral Castle, Everything You Know Is Wrong. Thanks a lot for watching. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.